What up, Dallas ISD? This is Coach Nelson with Coach Moody and Coach Bonda. We're here to put you through a little workout and have some fun with some activities. If you want to, go ahead and go grab you a couple socks. I got four here. It doesn't really matter. Coach Moody's got some paper balls. Coach Bonda has just some little foam balls. It's all good. Just go ahead and grab those and grab you a target of some sort. I got my giant lunchbox. Coach Bonda has a, what is that, an Amazon package? An Amazon package, that's all good. And Coach Moody has like a cylinder, like a trash can. All right, y'all go get that while we start warming up. You might know this song. All right, every time you hear Baby Shark, we're gonna be skipping. I like to go in a circle, but you can modify. You can stay in place like Coach Moody, it's all good. Just skipping. Mama Shark, I want you to gallop. You can even make a little shark. Biting if you want to. Ooh, Daddy Shark, get those knees up when you skip. High knee skips. Loosen up that body. Ooh, Grandma, how quick can you move your feet? How quick? Ooh, quicker feet. Alternating high kicks for Grandpa Shark. Loosen up them legs. Loosen up that body, get that blood pumping. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, try to spin in circles while you explore your area. Stay kind of low if you want to, any way you want to, really. What's that? An octopus. Shuffle. Loosen up those deltoids. Loosen up that groin. Ooh, jump. Seal. Jump. Take off with 2 feet, land on 2 feet. Jellyfish, we're gonna be lunging. I can do a little spear finger action with it. You can do whatever you want. Just have fun. Crab walk, another shuffle. I like to get low on this one. Baby shark, what do we do with that again? Skipping. We're skipping. This is a longer skip. How about we change direction? Still skipping. Warming that body up. My heart rate's getting up. My blood's pumping. Gallop, mama gallops. Working on that gallop. Sweating a little already. High knee skips. Get them up. Quick feet. How fast can you move your feet? Alternating high kicks. Try to keep your legs straight. You should feel a nice pull on that hamstring. I'm gonna change direction again. Last round, skipping. It's a 4 minute warm up. It's just a fun little song you can make movements to. Gallop. Galloping. High knee skips. Get that rhythm down. Quick feet, this one's my favorite. I don't know why, but it is. Alternating high kicks. All right. Feeling loose. I'm feeling warm. I'm ready. Are y'all ready, ladies? All sharks, just walk. Point yourself, fan yourself if you need to. Woo! Yeah. Up. Make yourself a fin. Get some swimmers in, just loosen up them shoulders a little bit. Ooh, I like that modification, Bonda. Dance, bust a move. I prefer the Carlton. Ah, walk and wave. Whew, we're done. All right, it's a good time to get a shot of water if you need it. Always keep water handy whenever you're doing exercise. You don't wanna drink a whole lot of water, you're not getting a chug. Just get a little sip. Ah, it tastes so good. High quality H2O. Also, a rag, a towel, whatever you wanna call it. That's also good. If you're like me, you sweat a lot, this bald head just glistens. So you need to wipe it off sometimes. That is all good. Now, our bodies are nice and warm. Is your body warm, Coach Moody?
Yes,
your body warm, Coach Bonda? Yeah. Now we're going to do a little exercise. First one we're going to do. Told you to grab some socks, paper balls, or foam balls. That's all good. First exercise. Everything we do, we're going to try to go for 1 minute. 1 whole minute. This first one, if you're familiar with a plank, you're going to be in a plank position. A lot of teachers teach this exercise as shoulder taps. Same concept, but we are focusing on your ball, your object, your socks, whatever it is. You're going to be tapping it back and forth, keeping your eye on the ball. It's going to take your mind off the pain in the core, possibly, and help you focus on something different. Y'all ready? You ready? Curbo 1 minute on the clock, please. Thank you, sir. Starting in 3, 2, 1, here we go. We're tapping it back and forth, back and forth. If this is pretty easy for you, good. You can widen your hands if you want to. Make sure that back stays flat, those hips are down, that core is engaged. This is a core exercise. So you really want to focus on keeping your body still and really just move your arms to move that ball. Back and forth. Let me check on my coaches real quick. Oh, perfect form, Coach Moody. That looks great. Back is nice and flat, looking great. Coach Bonda has more of a challenge with that ball because it rolls fast. But she's doing awesome. Excellent job, ladies. Here we go. Got about 20 more seconds. Let's finish out strong. All right. Feeling the burn?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Me too. And I didn't even do the whole thing. This is great. 10 seconds. Stay with us. We got this. All right. Doing great. Oh, yeah. 3, 2, 1. Relax. Whew. Sweat drip. Awesome. That was awesome. That was awesome. 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 Next, we're going to roll over to our backs. And we are going to do a little straight leg sit-ups. Very similar to sit-ups, but you're keeping your legs straight. Whoa. Tells you what to do. I like you to keep your hands high. When you go down, it engages more of the core. When you sit up, I want you to put the sock in between your feet. Try to hold the sock, paper ball, or ball with your toes. Again, take your mind off of the muscles you're actually working, and you focus on something different. We're going to do this for 1 whole minute. Every time you go down, sit up, switch your ball, sock, paper ball, whatever it is. Just alternate between the two. You got it, Coach Moody? You got it, Coach Bonda? Yep. Here we go. Curbo, can we get 1 minute on the clock, please? Woo-hoo. Thank you, sir. In 3, 2, here we go. Lay flat. Sit up. Back down. And up. Feeling good, ladies. I like some core exercises. There's a lot of muscles in that core. It's not just your abdomen. It also stretches to your lower back. So if you feel like you're really rolling on that lower back, that's okay. You can modify. Bring your knees up if you have to. And then just put the sock in between your knees. That is completely acceptable. It kind of takes a little pressure off, but the more challenging way to learn how to do a sit-up is keeping your legs straight. Whew, working hard, feeling good, having fun. That's what it's all about. We have about 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, and break. Great job. Whew, feeling it? Feeling it? I'm feeling it. I need a towel off again. Get your shot of water if you need to. Don't ever feel like you cannot get water. You're not in the gymnasium anymore. It's not 70 kids in a classroom. You can do it. Whenever you want. All right. Next exercise. We don't stop. We keep going. I'm going to switch balls just for fun, or socks. All right. Here we go. This one is going to require a little bit of skill. We're going to work on lateral movement. That's moving side to side. But first, we're going to get a little rhythm with our ball. Little rhythm. I'm doing one-handed. You can do two if you need to catch with two. That's fine. First, we're going to get that rhythm. I want you to get in what is called a ready stance. Ready stance is when your knees are slightly bent, your back is straight, your weight is slightly on your toes. That's ready. I call this down and ready. and I want you in ready position. Thank you, ladies, for getting in that side view for them. Ready position. And we're just gonna practice at it first, tossing our object back and forth, getting in the rhythm. Y'all got that? How you doing, ladies? Y'all doing good?
Yep.
All right. Now we're about to add the shuffle. When you shuffle, that's when the timer's gonna start. You're just catching your rhythm right now. When we shuffle, we're gonna try to go for one whole minute. It looks something like this. You're gonna shuffle, 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 shuffle. You're gonna toss the ball a little bit further away from you. You might get one, two, maybe three. You can catch with two hands if you're more comfortable catching with two. But the key is to toss the ball up, track it with your eyes, and try to catch it. Got it? Got it? Here we go. In three, two, go. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Ooh, back and forth. Back and forth. Stay focused on that ball. Keep your eye on the ball. Eye on the ball. Eye on the sock. Eye on the paper wad, whatever you're using. Back and forth. Back and forth. If you drop it, oh no, just shuffle on over and pick it up. Notice not one of us is trying to throw it too far away. We're keeping it what we call right in our kitchen, our little bubble. We're not trying to throw it far and Odell it, because we're not Odell. We are trying to learn the skills to eventually one day Odell a ball. Here we go. Here we go. What do we got? Oh, 10 more seconds. I think. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and break. Whew. Legs burning a little bit, yeah? I feel it on the inner thigh. I think that's the one that got my quadriceps the other day. All right, next exercise. Again, towel off, get a drink if you need it. We're going back to the ground. We're doing some more core exercises. I'm gonna have Coach Moody do a modification. Nope, Coach Bonda do a modification. She has a ball that kind of bounces, so she's gonna move back to the wall. And she's gonna sit up, bounce the ball off the wall, and try to catch it. To Coach Bonda, remember, we're not trying to pelt the wall, we're just trying to bounce it off and catch it. Demonstration, perfect, just like that. Coach Moody and I, we are gonna simply sit in that sit-up position. Once we sit up, we're gonna sit and shoot, catch it. Back down, sit, shoot, catch. Back down, if you're right-handed, shoot with the right hand. If you think you're ambidextrous, try with that left. It's okay, but you wanna keep the ball right in your area so you don't have to go chasing it. We're gonna start in 3, 2, 1 minute, go. Sit down, sit up, and catch. Down, up, catch. I'm alternating my hands just to challenge myself a little bit more. If you're having trouble tracking the ball and catching it, that's okay. Just do a sit up with it. You can even keep your hands behind your head. When you sit up, kind of lunge your arms forward. That's a modification because the momentum from your arms kind of pulls your body forward. More advanced version, if you feel like, I just don't got the skill to throw and catch, that's okay. Put the sock on your chest and do the old traditional sit-ups. Either way, any version is acceptable. Woo! Let's go see how they're doing because I'm struggling right now. Excellent job. Coach Moody's is doing the regular sit-up and throwing it. Excellent job, Coach Moody. Coach Bonda's doing great work over here. Great work, bouncing off that ball. Have you dropped one yet?
I have not.
She hasn't even dropped one. 5, 4, 3, 2, relax. Good job, ladies. Good job, kiddos. Last exercise of the day. Whew, I'm dripping sweat here. Oh, great workout. Last exercise, and then we're gonna get to some fun games. You're gonna take this sock, ball, paper, this one's fun actually. Paper ball's really fun with this one. Ball's gonna be the most challenging because it bounces. You're gonna take, it doesn't matter which arm because you're gonna switch, one arm. We're gonna get what's called a sumo squat position. That just means our legs are wider than shoulder width. So when we go down, our legs kind of go outwards instead of forwards. So kind of angle those toes out so those knees can go out. We're gonna hold the ball up, whatever it may be, and whenever you go down, you're gonna slam it down. Again, Coach Bonda, you might just wanna little toss. Coach Moody, I'm going to challenge you. You got to have small paper balls, but when you hit it, try to catch it before it hits the ground. It's really fun, and the paper ball kind of goes, yeah. It just increases the fun. You should also try to catch yours every time. 1 minute on the clock, starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, and here we go. Oh, first one was weak. Damn, don't forget to alternate those hands. Stay in that sumo position. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Also loosening up those shoulders. Oh, if you crumpled up your old homework, your last all A report card, great for you. Slam it down. Be upset, happy, mad, sad, glad that you do not have to go back to that classroom right now. But I know you're missing us, because we sure are missing you. 10 more seconds, ladies. Actually, I take that back. 10 more seconds now. Keep that back flat. Make sure you squat down whenever you throw it down. It's not just about the throw. Working that inner thigh. 3, 2, and relax. Excellent job, y'all. Whew, I'm gonna towel off. I guess y'all don't sweat as bad as me. All right. Great job. Get you a shot of water if you need it. That's all right. Yeah. Now, my heart rate's up. I'm breathing heavy. I'm sweating, all because I'm using energy to produce movements. Your body naturally cools itself off. So, this is not a bad thing. You want to sweat. You want to be breathing hard. You want that heart pumping. That means you're working. If you're not accomplishing this during your activity, try a little harder. Push yourself just that much further to accomplish a lot more. Now we need our targets. I'm sorry. Not this one just yet. That towel that I've been using, they haven't as much. We're gonna play this game first. You thought it was just to wipe off sweat, but no. We're gonna play a fun game. You lay the towel out in front of you. We're gonna learn about what 6 feet looks like, and you're gonna have to start thinking what it looks like on a daily basis, because with the new guidelines, we're supposed to keep 6 feet apart from one another. For an adult, it's usually 3 steps. For children, I've found, if you just take 4 regular steps, don't look down, try to take big steps, that never works. Look straight ahead from your towel. For children, 4 steps away, adults, 3. 1, 2, 3. Turn back around. That's about 6 feet apart. Children, again, 4 steps, but look straight ahead when you do it. Do not look down at the ground. Because if you look down at the ground, you're going to be doing the big steps, all right? 6 feet. Your objective is to land your ball, whatever ball it is, on the towel. If you land it on, you fold the towel in half. If you land it on again, fold it in half again. If you land it on again, you fold it in half again. This is kind of like Angry Birds. You know, you get stars on Angry Birds, 1 star, 2 star, 3 star. If you land it on the towel 3 times, that's a 1 star. If you land it on the towel 4 or 5 times, that's a 2 star, and if you land the ball on the towel 6 times, that's a 3 star. You pass no matter what, but you kind of judge how good you're doing based on your star system. After you fold the towel 3 times, let's say I've made it 3 times already. Look how small that target got. Then you have to unfold it, 1 at a time. So if I land on it again, I'm unfolding. If I land on it again, unfold, land on it again, unfold. That's what makes the challenge challenging. You ready, ladies?
Yes.
Everything we do is for 1 minute. We got 1 minute to win it. 3, 2, go. Trying to land the ball on. It, all the sock has to be doing, or ball, is touch the towel. As long as it's touching on the towel without moving, you can keep going. But if it touches it and bounces off, it doesn't count. That counts. Stayed on. Uh-oh, one more, and I got a 1 star. Don't be a no star, at least be a 1 star. Oh. All right, ladies, 30 seconds, gotta get moving.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, I'm touching it, good deal, good deal. I'm at 3 stars.
All right, here we go, here we go. Gotta let it roll up there.
Uh-oh, 10 seconds. 10 seconds. Oh, that's touching, sweet! Oh, one more, I gotta get a 2 star. 3, 2.
I want the
Told you, I practiced with the socks. So,
they're a little bit better.
That is level one.
Ooh, that's level one. That's good.
Level one. Level two. We still need that towel. It's still laid out 6 feet away. That's roughly 6 feet. You want the socks?
I want a pair of socks.
Because you're not going to like this next one.
What is it, easier? I'm trading mine out for a pair of
socks. Oh, Coach Moody just asked if it's easier. Do levels get harder or easier as you progress through a game?
I guess it gets to get harder.
It's getting harder. All right. So, same concept. You're throwing, trying to make it on. If you make it on, cool. Fold it. When you come back, you have to do one burpee. If you miss, don't worry about it. Just keep trying until you make it. Only if you make it, you have to do a burpee. Every time you make it, you do one burpee when you come back over here. Got it, Coach Moody? Got it, Coach Bonda?
That's why you gave me the socks.
Yes, it is. Starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, yeah. Oh, got one. That's not a bad thing.
Only if you leave.
If it's touching the towel at all when it comes to rest.
Ugh. Oh,
ah, bummer. Working on backpedaling as I'm coming back, having fun with this game. This is a great game to challenge. Yes! Your parents, especially your dads. If your dad's like cornhole, they're probably going to be really good at this game. Oh, we got 30 seconds, ladies. Is that touching? It's touching! I'm out at a 1 star! Woo! Now I really gotta get some loft under me. 15 seconds. Oh, stay on! 15 seconds. 15 seconds. Oh, 10 seconds. 10 seconds. Oh, I don't think I did. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2. Good job. How far did you get?
I only got to there.
How many? 3? Whew. Now, we're not going to do the other two because I want to show y'all one more game. But level 3, non-dominant hand. Just like level 1, but you're throwing with your non-dominant hand. You don't have to do burpees if you make it. Same star system. Level 4, ooh, non-dominant. If you make it, you have to do a burpee. Have fun with that one. Now, last game of the day. We got enough time to show you one more. Find that target that I told you to find. Again, mine's a giant lunchbox, got an Amazon package, we got a trash can looking thing over here. Good, 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 good. Whew. We are gonna do 6 feet away, and you can move anywhere because you're trying to remember what 6 feet looks like. So if I throw one and it lands way over there, that's okay. I can now throw it from way over here. You're working on judging what 6 feet looks like. So you're not going to have a perfect spot on the floor, because when you go meet somebody, you're not going to have a stick or something that says, stay 6 feet away. You have to learn how to observe 6 feet without a ruler or anything to measure. So same concept, same game, any object you have, any ball you have, you're just shooting it, trying to make it in. You can challenge your friends, family, anything. As a matter of fact, I'm going
to
use paper balls.
Kobe?
All right, let's see it. I'd rather LeBron it. Ugh, just slam it, but you know. What do you got? 3, 2, 1. 1 minute on the clock. All those are off. Paper balls. Oh, that's not 6 feet.
2.
Oh, there's one. Oh, and if you make one, you can't shoot from the exact same spot. You gotta move. Challenge yourselves. I got 2. We're all moving all around the gym, practicing spatial awareness, understanding what 6 feet looks like. I got 3. Oh man, got a catcher. I don't know if I'm going to. Ah, bummer. Uh-oh. We got 15 seconds. I got four. Oh, from downtown, okay. We have 10 seconds.
Wow. Started off.
Three, two, and buckets.
Good job.
That was nice. Good work. Awesome. All right. Those are just some fun games. You probably have all that stuff sitting around your house somewhere. Make a game out of anything. Amazon package, trash can, paper ball, socks. Find something, make a game out of it. We're going to end with a few stretches. Thank y'all for joining us today. Just remember, when you do stretch, try to hold that stretch for 30 seconds or longer. You're not benefiting your body by just going, ugh, touch my toes, woo, that was good. You need to hold the stretch. That's where you find the benefits of stretching. All right, first thing we're going to do before I towel off, or after, sorry. We're going to reach high to the sky. Big breath in. Exhale on your way down. Try to touch those toes. I like to go for 45 seconds and have a 15-second transition period where I transition from one stretch to another. But we're probably going to go for 30 seconds just because we don't have a whole lot of time left. You should be feeling this in your hamstrings, your glutes, and your lower back. Maybe even your calves. If your calves are tight, you might even feel it all the way down your calves. Oh, you don't have to do anything but hang down. You don't have to touch your toes if you can't. If you're good at it, most females are really good at this. They can like bend in half. But if you're not like me, you can grab the back of the heels and kind of pull yourself in to get a better stretch. But remember, you got to hold it if you do that. Three, two, relax. Come up slow. It's kind of like a rubber band. When you pull a rubber band, if you let go, it's just going to pop. So let's not pop our muscles. Next one we're going to do. Oh, we did some core exercises today. We're going to do what I call an ab stretch. We're going to lay down on the ground. Put your hands next to your chest, lying flat on the ground. Whenever we come up, we're just going to push our upper bodies off the ground, leaving our hips and legs on the ground. Coming up in three, two, push up. Oh, extend those arms. Keep those hips to the ground. I can see Coach Bonda stretching her head back. That's awesome. Some of you can probably even touch your toes to the back of your head. I've seen that. I can't do that. I'm an old man. So I'm just going to do this. Looking up to the sky. Letting your belly buttons drop to the ground. Relax. Focus on the breathing. Oh, this was a good workout today. Feeling good, ladies? Is it? It feels good. Oh, if you bring your hands in closer, you get even more of a stretch. Oh, yeah, now I'm feeling it. Looking straight up to the ceiling. Three, two, come down slow, and relax. Thank y'all for joining us today, and we'll see you next week. Bye, y'all.
Good workout.